Hello student, welcome for today's session. In today's session, we are going to perform preparation of ferrous sulfate. The learning objectives for preparation of ferrous sulfate, first of all, to know the aim and requirements, to study the monograph of ferrous sulfate, principle of preparation of ferrous sulfate, procedure, calculation and result. So the aim of our today's practical is to prepare the ferrous sulfate preparation. For this, we require following requirements. We require glassware, beakers, glass rods, measuring cylinder, filter paper, funnel, stand, etc. Apart from this, we require the following chemicals: iron, dilute sulfuric acid. So first of all, let know the monograph of ferrous sulfate, IP. The synonym of ferrous sulfate, it is also known as green vitriol, iron vitriol. The molecular formula is FeSO4 with the 7 water molecule. Molecular weight is 278.02. It should contain not less than 98% and not more than 103.35% of ferrous sulfate with the 7 water molecule. So, first of all, the preparation of ferrous sulfate, it is prepared by dissolving iron dust or fillings in the excess of dilute sulfuric acid. The iron dissolves with the effervescence and H2 gas is liberated. When the reaction subsides, the liquid is boiled to concentrate, filtered and cooled thereafter to obtain the crystals, which are filtered and dried at the room temperature. The reaction involved in the ferrous sulfate preparation is Fe plus H2SO4 and number of water molecule that we give FeSO4 with the 7 water molecule and evaluation of H2 gas. So the properties of ferrous sulfate, it is a pale bluish green crystalline or granular solid which is odorless with the saline metallic astringent taste. It is efflorescent intra air and may get oxidized to ferric salt, having brownish color. The ferrous sulfate is acidic to the litmus paper with the pH about 3.7. It is soluble in water but practically insoluble in alcohol. When heated, it decomposes to ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide and sulfuric acid. So this is the reaction about the decomposition. Dose is given 200 mg twice or thrice a day. The assay of ferrous sulfate is done by the redox titration. Aqueous sample solution is titrated against 0.1 normal Kelvin for solution in presence of dilute sulfuric acid to a colored endpoint. The reaction involved in the assay is 2FeSO4 plus 2KNO4 plus 4H2SO4 that will give K2SO4. Uses: the ferrous sulfate preparations are widely used in the form of oral iron preparations like tablet, capsule, syrup, reconstitutable dry powders, etc. Mainly the use of ferrous sulfate is hematinics, that means these are the iron supplement preparations which promoting the formation of hemoglobin to treat the iron deficiency, in particularly in uncomplicated anemias. So the dose is 200 mg twice or thrice a day. Now the principle involved in the today's practical preparation. The preparation of ferrous sulfate is based upon the reaction between iron metal with the dilute sulfuric acid. Ferric ion is converted ferrous sulfate, the evaluation of hydrogen gas. The reaction is allowed until evaluation of hydrogen gas ceases. So overall reaction is Fe plus H2SO4 with the evaluation of H2 gas and formation of FeSO4. So ferric ion sulfate, British English, that is iron sulfate or ferrous sulfate, denotes a range of salts with the formula FeSO4 with the X water molecule. This compound exists more commonly as the heptahydrates but are known for the several values of X. The hydrated form is usually medically to treat iron deficiency and also for industrial applications. This is also having some side effects like constipations and uncomfortable side effects associated with the administration of oral iron supplements. So let's know the procedure for today's practical. In today's practical, first of all, we have to weigh 2 gram of iron powder, and we have to add it to 20 to 25 ml dilute sulfuric acid and allow to stand for 3 minutes. When the effervescence of hydrogen is stopped, that is completely evolution of hydrogen gas stops, then we have to concentrate the liquid. Either way, we have to take filter out the impurities present in that, and we have to concentrate in evaporating dish. After cooling the solution, greenish crystals are formed. A filtration technique is carried out to separate out the greenish crystals if it is done by the recrystallization techniques. So this is about our procedure we will actually going to perform this practical in laboratory.
Today's lecture we are going to perform preparation of ferrous sulfate. The aim of our today's practical is to prepare ferrous sulfate. For this, we require requirement of chemicals, required iron powder, dilute sulfuric acid, distilled water, etc. Glass pairs, we required beaker, water bath, glass rod, funnel, burner, that is filtration assembly, etc. Now the principle of today's practical, the preparation of ferrous sulfate, it depends upon, that is, it is the most common method of preparation of ferrous sulfate by reacting or by allowing to react iron metal powder with dilute sulfuric acid. Here, iron powder reacts with the dilute sulfuric acid and forms a ferrous sulfate, that is greenish colored solution with the evolution of hydrogen gas. Whenever the reaction is complete, that when the hydrogen gas evolution ceases, it means the reaction is completed, we get the greenish solution, or we obtain a greenish solution which we require to concentrate. After concentration, the ferrous sulfate crystallizes out as a greenish colored product. The ferrous sulfate is also known as green vitriol. The synonym of this ferrous sulfate is green vitriol. Here the reaction of preparation of ferrous sulfate, Fe2 plus with H2SO4, that will give the ferrous sulfate with the evolution of hydrogen gas. So this is the simple principle behind preparation of ferrous sulfate. As per our requirement, we require iron metal powder. So we require iron metal powder. Okay. Then dilute sulfuric acid and a distilled water. So this is our chemical requirement. Similarly, we require measuring cylinder, a porcelain dish, and pair of tongs, filtration assembly, funnel, and tripod stand. Now, as per the procedure, very first of all, we require to weigh 2 gram of iron metal powder. So here already we have weighed 2 gram of iron metal powder. Now the first step is we have to transfer 20 ml of dilute sulfuric acid in porcelain dish. We can also perform this practical in the beaker. So here we will take 20 ml of dilute sulfuric acid transfer it into the porcelain dish. Either we will take porcelain dish or we also can take a beaker. We can also transfer this dilute sulfuric acid in the beaker. Now, next step is addition of this 2 gram of iron metal powder, which is already we have weighed. We have to transfer this 2 gram of iron metal powder in a dilute sulfuric acid. After addition of powder into the dilute sulfuric acid, there will the evolution of hydrogen gas takes place. We have to wait until this evolution of H2 gas completely ceases. So we have to wait for a few minutes. Now, we will allow to concentrate the solutions. A green color solution which is obtained after complete reaction of the dilute sulfuric acid with the here we are allowing to concentrate the solutions after complete reaction of or a complete evolution of the H2 gas. The gas is completely ceased, then we got the greenish colored solution here. We will allow the solution to concentrate for a few minutes. So the excess amount of water present that will get evaporated here. Allow to concentrate the solution completely so that after filtration we will get the concentrated solution. So we required you to allow to stand for a few minutes for cooling. So here we have to take care that we have to allow to completely react the whatever be the iron powder what we have taken in solution of dilute sulfuric acid. We have to allow it to completely react so that the H2 gas is completely ceased, and after that whatever the green solution we have obtained, we have to concentrate it in the porcelain dish. So right now this solution is concentrated. We will wait for 2 minutes. After complete concentration, we will filter this solution. And allow to cool it. So whatever impurities are present or unreacted ion impurities are present, that will be remain on the filter paper and we will get the finished solution. Here we obtain a green colored solution, which is a clear solution of ferrous sulfate solution.
We will allow it concentrate completely here. Completely evaporate the water. Now here we got a greenish product. Allow it to cool for completely. After completely crystallization, we get a solid product of green color. We'll transfer it into the petri dish. So here, complete dry green colored product is obtained. Here a complete dried green colored product is, which is known as a ferrous sulfate crystals. So here we got a green colored ferrous sulfate crystalline product. So this is our the end product. Now we will wait this. We will weigh this product.
Now we are going to perform calculation part for preparation of ferrous sulfate. As already we have seen, the reaction involved in the preparation of ferrous sulfate is whenever the iron powder, that is Fe2+, is treated with the dilute sulfuric acid, it gives formation of ferrous sulfate, a greenish crystalline product with the evolution of H2 gas. So as per the reaction, we have to calculate the theoretical yield. Here, the molecular weight of iron is 56 gram per mole, and we get from the reaction FeSO4 having the molecular weight 278 gram per mole. So we have to calculate the theoretical yield. Here, as 56 gram of iron powder gives 278 gram of FeSO4, then 2 gram of iron powder will use how much quantity of FeSO4? That is to be known as a theoretical yield. After calculation, we have to make the cross multiplication 2 into 278 divided by 56. That will use 9.93 gram of ferrous sulfate as a theoretical yield. So X is here 9.93 gram ferrous sulfate. Now, as after performing the practical, we get 7.08 gram of ferrous sulfate. That means our practical yield Y is 7.08 gram. Now, we have to calculate the percentage practically. That means how much amount of, at how much percentage we got the product. Here, to calculate the percentage practically, the formula is practically divided by theoretically into 100. So here, our practically 7.08 and theoretically that is 9.93 into 100. After calculation, we got 78.29%. That means near about 71% of product we have obtained. So we have to write down the result here. In writing the result, we have to write down that the preparation of ferrous sulfate shows following results. Theoretically, X is 9.93 gram of ferrous sulfate. Practically, whatever we got the practically, that is 7.08 gram of ferrous sulfate. Percent practically 71.29%. And the category of today's product, that is ferrous sulfate, is imatinib. Imatinib, these are the preparations which are useful in the treatment of iron deficiency or anemic conditions.
So student, here after performing the practical and we got the preparation of ferrous sulfate, by taking the weight and performing the calculation, we got the following result for preparation of ferrous sulfate. The theoretical yield is 9.93 gram. Practical yield, whatever we got practically, is 7.08 gram. From the calculation of percentage practical yield, we got 71.29% product here. Our today's practical was preparation of ferrous sulfate. The category of ferrous sulfate is imatinib. And finally, we can conclude the result that we have prepared the ferrous sulfate and submitted. Now, we will look for some WIVA questions and some MCQ questions. So first question is, what is anemia? As earlier we have discussed that anemia is the deficiency of iron due to some disease conditions or disorder conditions. There is loss of RBCs or breakdown of RBCs and or improper supplement of food nutritional supplements that lead to the anemia or deficiency of iron is known as anemia. And for this treatment of anemia, we are using imatinib preparation, that is ferrous sulfate. The principle behind preparation of ferrous sulfate. So earlier, as already we have discussed, the principle of ferrous sulfate preparation is, that is, whenever we allow to react the iron metal powder with the dilute sulfuric acid, that will causes evolution of H2 gas and formation of ferrous sulfate. So we require to concentrate the liquid so that we get finally the ferrous sulfate product. The reaction, next question is, write the reaction involved in the preparation of ferrous sulfate. As earlier we have discussed that the reaction involved Fe plus H2SO4, that will give formation of FeSO4 with the evolution of H2 gas. Next is, what are the application of ferrous sulfate? The major application of ferrous sulfate is the as a iron supplement preparations. They are mainly used as imatinib. They are also useful in the pregnant woman's or as a supplement of iron. What is the side effect of ferrous sulfate? The side effect of ferrous sulfate is most of this ferrous sulfate shows constipations, and as these are the oral preparation, these are also shows some side effects which are associated with the oral preparations. The next is MCQs. First MCQ is following the example of Fumitinix. So here options are A, zinc sulfate, copper sulfate, ammonium chloride, and D is ferrous sulfate. So correct option is here ferrous sulfate, that is D. Second MCQ is Fumitinix are the preparation used for the treatment of. First option is diarrhea, second anemia, C both A and B, D is none of these. So here the correct option is anemia. During the preparation of ferrous sulfate, gases evolve. A nitrogen, B oxygen, C hydrogen, D none of the above. Correct option is again hydrogen. Next MCQ is assay of the ferrous sulfate is done by. First option is complex metric titration method. B option is acid base titration method. C option is redox titration method. D is all of the above. So here correct option is redox titration method. Next MCQ is ferrous sulfate is also known as. So what is the synonym of ferrous sulfate? So here options are blue vitriol, red vitriol, green vitriol, none of the above. So correct option is here green vitriol. So thank you. Here we have completed our preparation of ferrous sulfate along with the procedure, performance and some assignment questions. I hope questions. Thank you.